Fire Emblem series.
Sonic?
Is it Sonic? Arc?
Arc has a Sonic?
The Sonic, yeah, he does.
Very cool. I did not know that about him.
He has a very polished Sonic.
Interesting.
It's not the best Sonic ever. Because, you know, like 6WX, that, you know, he exists. But it's a very, very good Sonic.
I didn't know he played Sonic. I just knew about his mostly just his Corrin.
Now he's been pulling out Sonic more. So
Sonic
is
very difficult
this.
For Michigan in general to deal with. I know we don't see LKT outside of MSU too awful often. I know that Lou Rich is from MSU. I don't know if Lou Rich really goes to any of the stuff at MSU, but that's like one of the like two other Sonics in Michigan.
Yeah. Arc by no means main Sonic, but it's definitely not a bad match.
I can see why this would be super good for Arc, just because A, it forces Ike to approach, and Ike doesn't have the best approach options, and he's pretty slow. As well as offstage, Sonic should be able to basically massacre Ike.
Oh yeah, you just run off stage and spring.
Say spring, or you can do like if he's trying to recover low, you can run off and do one of his aerials. Like Sonic can down air pretty freely. I don't know if that'll impact this matchup, but he can also just like run off and fair and push Ike away, because Ike can either go sideways or he can go up. Those are his two options. So if he's kind of in the middle ground trying to go upwards, then he's gonna have lots and lots of problems.
Oh yeah, you can see right now Arc taking a pretty decent lead right now, 81% to 14 here. In favor of Arc.
It's exactly what you want as a Sonic. And good just
great.
Wait
oh,
there.
The taunt. Arc's just like, yeah, you can't do that here.
And he's just going to pummel him for some extra percentages there.
I thought I would have followed that up with a spring to up air. I think that would have done it.
Well, like you said, this isn't like Arc's main by any means. So he might not have that on the brain.
You know, he might just be thinking what can he do that's confirmed, instead of what can I maybe do.
Exactly. He might be just going for more guaranteed stuff. He's got a nice lead, and he's just gonna call out that ledge get up option with a 3/4 away charge forward smash.
Say what you will about Sonic, his forward smash is so much fun to land.
I like the wind up on it. He's
reverse
spinning around. There we go. We're seeing LKT get in an advantage state for really the first time, and he's doing something with it.
Really for the first time in about 2 minutes into this game. Although, back to neutral, though.
He's starting to figure this matchup out a little bit better. Using a lot more jabs and things of that nature to try to stuff out Sonic approaches.
I think it's just a matter of... Honestly, I think this is really in favor of Arc, just because... I mean, Sonic spin dashes and then jumps, and then how does Ike punish that? Because there's, like, nothing. Ike's just too slow for... Ike's just too slow to catch Sonic, and I know that sounds kind of ironic.
Oh, he whipped two rabs.
Oh, and the taunt back. Prepare yourself.
He's only got 54% on him. This is very, very doable. He's starting to get the hang of this matchup for sure.
Oh yeah. He's definitely more comfortable now that he took that first stock. You can see it in his play style.
He can't get overzealous though, but he's getting there. LKT, I think he's one of MSU's hidden gems, because I had no idea LKT was this good.
And I actually do have a saying when we talk about don't get overzealous. I have a saying. It's play fast, but don't play excited. Because I do that a lot sometimes when I'm in like really, really close sets, is I get excited and start looking for kill options when I just don't
when they're
have
not
anything
there,
to
yeah.
confirm that, like, I don't have anything to confirm them into. And it's just bad for me, because I usually die because of it.
Oh, he was trying to go for that up tilt right there, but he's going to get grabbed.
Ooh.
Oh, very smart option there, and that's super close. We're going for eruption right here.
Back air safe on shield. Not going to get the grab for it.
Oh, and he's just going to get eaten up smash.
Perfect pivot F smash. PBFF.
Do you think we're going to see a switch out of Arc here? That was very, very close.
That was very close, but I think it's more so that Arc just started... I don't want to play down LKT at all, but I think Arc started to fall asleep there a little bit, and that's why. Because that was a very dominant first stock from Arc.
I think maybe what happened was LKT... adapted to what was going on, and then Art counter-adapted. Rather than just like kind of falling asleep on him. I think it was just a counter-adaption, in all honesty.
Yeah, that also could be the case. Like I said, I'm not trying to downplay LKT. I don't know how good he is or what matchups he doesn't know. So if he just didn't know the matchup at the start, that's my beat.
Sonics are so hard to come by, especially competent Sonics.
Because a lot of them just like to side B, and then just do the one thing where they just side B and then jump, and then side B and then jump, and side B and then jump. That's all they want to do. That's what my Sonic does, and that's fraudulent. Like you try to go to get it cashed at like the tier list, and they'll be like, nope, it's fraud.
Yeah, fraud.
The tier bank. All right, though, looking like Ark's going to be taking a second here, thinking about some stuff, thinking maybe a switch off. I could see the switch off.
Honestly, thinking and taking a breath is so good in between games. You've got 30 seconds. You might as well use them to get yourself recentered. Because a lot of times, like a set like that, it can be or a game like that, it can be very nerve-wracking.
Oh, yeah. A good example for me recently is like my set with King James earlier. Like, my heart after that entire set was pounding out of my chest. I was so, excited.
Right, exactly.
All right, game two. Going to be going back to Battlefield here.
I like this. It gives LKT a lot of landing options.
Neutral.
I mean, that's something that you are going to see with Sonic. You just... He can play as patiently as what he wants to because he's got all the speed.
Something that Ark has failed to catch so far is LKT's opting a lot to use the side B to recover onto the platform.
Yes.
Instead of the ledge. And I think if Ark caught that, it could be...
It'd probably scare LKT, in all honesty. Because, yeah, he's been going to the platform a lot because Ark hasn't been punishing it. And, like, if it's not broke, don't fix it. Oh, that was excellent right there.
Great spacing. Down throw, force an edge guard.
Nope, spring, but it's just going to get snuffed out by that sword.
By a Ragnell. I love all the names of the different Fire Emblem swords. They're so much fun. Falchion, Ragnell. Anyway, though, you're going to see Ark. Excuse me. Ark taking center stage here.
And gonna fall right into that grab there.
Tries to get the two frame, misses it. LKT gonna be down thrown again, trying to force another edge guard.
Oh no!
Oh no!
I think that was a misinput. It had to have been. He looks stunned.
That looks oh.
That is. That's a little heartbreaking right there. Sometimes you just get your stick at a little bit of a diagonal angle, and then you just drop off to the blast zone because you did up B instead of side B.
Or side B instead of up B in my case.
Exactly.
Eh.
Oh,
tries to go for the runoff air. That's something we haven't seen at all from LKT. So definitely a good option, although Ark is always ready for it.
Uh-oh.
Three fares. Three!
The count is with us. There, I got that one.
Hey, good.
That's good ops. Sharking pressure right there.
Really, really, I don't know. I follow that.
And
Bear to knock him off stage.
Bear. That's
tries to get the grab, misses it though, and is going to eat an F tilt. Ark now off stage. Bear, that's not safe on shield, buddy.
Nope, and he's going to get that up tilt right there. I've seen LKT get a lot of kills with that. People just aren't respecting his shield and they do something dumb, and then he's like, up tilt, you're dead.
Yep, rip you. Up throw, up air, not
trying to get the up air there.
Grab, back throw to get him off stage. Yep. Ooh, and you can see Ark went to go catch him on that platform now. Ark's learning.
Yep, trying to get that adaptation.
Oh, man.
Actually falling out right there of the fair. It's a little bit unfortunate for Ark. And this is getting danger zone for Ark. Ike kills incredibly early.
Oh, yeah, and even now with Rage. Oh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh.
Oh, he's going to get him.
Yep.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, we're going to go 1-1 now.
Woo!
Ike hitting him with that eruption, sending Sonic up and to the moon.
Yes.
Boom.
Just blowing him right on back. That's kind of crazy.
That is. I think we might see Ark switch for now. Off to Corrin. I don't know how comfortable he is in the Corrin Ike match.
I think Corrin runs over Ike a little bit because side B.
Corrin does win the matchup, but it's just a matter of does he know it?
And it looks like we are going to say Sonic.
Going to say Sonic, and it did I see FD? Yes, I did see FD. All right.
Yes, final.
Final destination is our final stage pick.
No,
except not really.
Not really, because it's best of five.
Best of five.
Shoutouts to your TO group for making all of this best of five, getting us lots more great Smash action.
Oh, yeah. No, it's definitely great because a lot of people, especially like lower-level players, don't get a lot of experience in 3 out of 5s.
So yeah, they're kind of hard to come by. A lot of times, like you said, you have to be out of your venue at a certain time, so you can't afford to do a bunch of sets 3 out of 5.
Yeah. All right, now we're going to see how we're going to have to see how LKT recovers now that there's no platforms to mess around with.
I think Ark acknowledged, hey, I'm having a hard time covering all of his options because he's mixing it up just enough to where it's a problem for me. And he's going to eat that back here, though. Ark is looking so dominant right now, this early going of this Game 3. Basically now, LKT's really only real option is to just snap to the ledge, basically, or go high if Ark gets greedy and goes off stage to try to get something.
Up air, not taking it quite yet. F
Ooh,
smash.
F smash. We'll go ahead and take it. Just wind him up and punch him out.
Yep. Sonic's F smash. It's so good and it's so satisfying when you land it. It's like you just hear it hit and it's just yes. Kind of like anything with Ike. Like
Ooh,
that.
Excellent read right there, just trapping his landing.
Oh, yeah, and that up smash, too, just so powerful.
I think that's the first smash attack we've really seen LKT throw this whole entire set. That's excellent, like, patience. And getting the re-grab right there. Oh, man, LKT just has, like, this almost magical ability to bring things back.
Forcing attack. Oh, doesn't read the tech, or doesn't get the attack in. F smash will knock him off stage, though.
Oh, and
Ooh,
there we
tries
are.
Tries to catch the high recovery with the up smash. Not going to catch that, though, either.
That is one of the weakest up smashes in the game as well. So it would have been a little bit of percent, but that's really all it would have been.
I did not know that Sonic's was one of the weakest.
Yes, it's actually one of the weakest.
Back throw knocks him off stage.
Ooh! See, now I think he's getting a little too antsy with these smash attacks. Like, the one was really good. You had him in a disadvantage state. He could only drift so far. So he basically covered like a lot of the stuff he could do, but that one was just it's a little too greedy because Ike's smash attacks are not fast either.
Oh no, no, they are some of the slowest if I remember.
See, I don't remember the exact frame data on Ike's forward smash, but I know it's not good.
And I tell you, but my phone's kind of dead.
Oh, and good dash attack coming through here. And we're seeing an eruption get charged up.
Oh,
and he's
going
to catch him again. LKT is going to go up 2-1. But this is best of five. So we are going to see at least two more games. Or at least one more game, excuse me. Yeah.
We're going to be going up 2-1 right now. LKT's favor. Don't know if Ark's definitely thinking. He's wondering about where to go, what to do. And you can see it right now.
And there's
up
that
smash.
Up smash read.
Yep, bam.
LKT is doing some good stuff right now. And
yep,
we are going to see the Corrin.
We are going to see the Corrin.
There we go.
Ark going back to his old tried and true. Corrin. Yeah, Corrin.
Yes.
Yes.
I think we've established that he plays Corrin mostly.
No, he plays Corrin.
Oh, Corrin.
Corrin, I'm coming.
And LKT getting that color counter pick.
The color counter pick. Oh, yeah. It's so important. I've lost games because I wasn't on my ult.
Oh, LKT with this stifling pressure. There we go.
This is definitely going to be weird. Ooh, Ark goes and tries to contest that Aether. Not going to find it, though.
He can counter it, though, which can be very, very scary.
Spot dodges the grab, although it's going to just get hit by another one anyway.
What I think is what's maybe tripping up Ark is that LKT is basically just going for safe options. There's an excellent back air right there. But like he'll go like grab, but then he'll go jab right afterwards. He's just trying to go for like the safest possible plays. And I don't know how much Ike experience Ark really has.
Yeah, there's no real prominent Ike at RC neither, so.
I know a lot of the Ikes got dropped for Corrin and Cloud.
Oh yeah, because why play a slow big sword when you play a fast big sword?
Yes. LKT's kind of making an argument for Ike, though.
Yeah.
He's doing some very good things
like,
right
I'm
now.
Not going to be replaced.
There we go.
Reads,
good neutral air into fair.
The jump. Grab up air. Little too high of a percent.
Oh!
That's what Ark does. He loves to do that. He loves to charge it just a little bit more, so you'll drop your shield thinking, oh, percent, thinking you,
You'll get a punish.
You're just going to...
Yes.
You'll just shield it, and then that's going to be it. But no, they'll shield it, and then drop it, and then he
bites
it. No,
you just got to hold shield on that, and just like, take the shield damage.
Oh, no, don't shield that. It's easy to break.
Well, what are you supposed to do then? Are you
roll.
No, roll. I guess roll away.
Roll, spot dodge, pray. I don't know. And we are going to see Ark going back to a little more of his spacing self.
See, I think that's what he needs to do, because we saw him... in losers for pools, I can't remember off the top of my head who he was fighting, but he had an advantage the whole time, and he was playing very defensively, and it was just super duper impressive. Oh, a script kitty. And script just couldn't get in. And I think that's what you want to see out of Ike, or out of Ark, excuse me, not Ike. Also, Ike has played very defensively well.
Yeah, speaking of defensively, you can see all of these, all of these attacks, they're just barely hitting shields. I want to keep them as far away from each other as possible, because they don't want to get hit by either of their swords.
One thing we have never seen from LKT is the counter. I'm curious to see if he'll break it out at some point.
Can we just talk about how many power shields that just was?
I think
it was like three.
It was a lot.
I get 123.
Trying to get an up tilt there, almost taking it. Or almost coming out there.
Ark tries to contest with F smash, not gonna find anything though.
And the
gentleman
jab,
not taking
not
it either.
Taking it. Oh my goodness, this is so close.
That was a great fall down in order to prevent getting hit from that Dragon Fang shot.
My heart is racing just for these players. I can't imagine how they must be right now. And the forward tilt, not gonna take it either. Ark is getting a lot of hits.
Oh man.
Again.
And
that will
do
it.
All right, game five.
Game
first game five of top 24, I think.
Wait, Ark was wrapping up his controller like he was done.
He's just like, that's it. There's
so
no more
trick to this is you got to flick up.
Oh, that's
it's
that's
very
neato.
Sensitive.
Neato. Yeah. Oh no, sorry. It's our second game five.
It's the first game five on stream though.
First game five on stream. Get hype.
So this is super duper close right now. Oh my goodness. It looks like Smashville may be the choice.
Smashville going for last game. Ark has this movement and he's so, so good with it. There's a thing that he'll do. He loves to do it. You'll see him. He'll pin on the mobile platform,
mm-hmm.
move forward, and then he loves to B-reverse a Dragon Fang shot after
Woo!
That.
Woo! That sounds crisp. Hopefully we'll see that come out. Oh, no! SD! Oh, no! That's
no.
so unfortunate!
Oh, I'm sorry.
And there's not going to be a buddy stock in this scenario.
No.
Oh, he's just taunting?
Oh, he's not doing it. He's not having it.
That is so unfortunate.
That is. And it's not even like he had any percent or anything. It was,
no.
it was at zero,
no.
basically.
I mean, I guess Ark can go for the JB3 now.
Potentially.
Oh my goodness. That's such a damper on this otherwise amazing set. Oh my goodness.
I think you can really tell that just got into LKT's head.
Yep.
Oh
and
my gosh.
Go.
JV.
Yep. That just totally destroyed all his momentum, which I can understand exactly where that's coming from.
Oh yeah, I know. A very, very unfortunate SD, and that just killed LKT's momentum coming into game five.
Just destroying.